Ouch, that's gonna hurt.
War. War never changes. When atomic fire consumed the Earth, those who survived did so in great underground vaults. When they opened, their inhabitants set out across the ruins of the old world to build new societies, establishing villages, forming tribes. As decades passed, what had been the American Southwest united beneath the flag of the new California Republic, dedicated to old world values of democracy and the rule of law. As the Republic grew, so did its needs. Scouts spread east, seeking territory and wealth in the dry and merciless expanse of the Mojave Desert. They returned with tales of a city untouched by the warheads that had scorched the rest of the world, and a great wall spanning the Colorado River. The NCR mobilized its army and sent it east to occupy Hoover Dam and restore it to working condition. But across the Colorado, another society had arisen under a different flag. A vast army of slaves forged from the conquest of 86 tribes, Caesar's Legion. 4 years have passed since the Republic held the dam, just barely, against the Legion's onslaught. The Legion did not retreat. Across the river, it gathers strength. Campfires burn, training drums beat. Through it all, the New Vegas Strip has stayed open for business under the control of its mysterious overseer, Mr. House, and his army of rehabilitated tribals and police robots. You are a courier, hired by the Mojave Express to deliver a package to the New Vegas Strip. What seemed like a simple delivery job has taken a turn for the worse.
This doesn't look good.
You got what you were after, so pay up.
You're crying in the rain, Pally.
Guess who's waking up over here?
Time to cash out.
Will you get it over with?
Maybe cons kill people without looking them in the face. But I ain't a fink. Dig? You've made your last delivery, kid. Sorry you got twisted up in this scene. From where you're kneeling must seem like an 18-carat run of bad luck.
Yeah.
No, don't do that. Oh god, no. Ow. Okay, so hate to play spoiler, but I am not dead. I hope. So welcome. And once this loads to my new let's play of Fallout New Vegas. And yeah, we're gonna get a lot of mods, as you'll see in the description. Caravan pack. Can't just enter. New Vegas bounties. So yes. I'm just seeing bright white light. Oh. I think it's starting to come into focus. Please stop popping off.
You're awake.
I am.
How about that?
Yeah, how about that? More perks. Yeah. Get out of my face.
Whoa, okay. Easy.
You're the doc.
Been cold a couple of days now.
Have I?
Why don't you just relax a sec? Get your bearings. Let's see what the damage
just
is.
Just that thing in the background.
How about your name? Can you tell me your name?
Match thing. My name is certainly not Courier. What should I be called? I can't seem to recall my name. Let's go with Pete. Oh, no, no. Bill? What sounds more cowboy-like? I don't know. Pete. Alright, so we are Pete. I am Pete.
I can't say it's what I'd have picked for you, but if that's your name, that's
your
name.
Oh, getting sassy, are we?
Welcome to Good Springs. Now, I hope you
happy to be here, I guess.
I want to go rooting around there in your noggin to pull all the bits of lead out.
Oh.
I take pride in my needlework.
Saved my life, so I hope I don't mind. Alright. Let's see what I look like. I do not look like this guy. Kind of looks like David Hasselhoff. I don't know. Ooh. Close up. Too close. Alright. Anyway, so yes, I am not a female. Ew. That preset is terrible. Oh, okay, they changed the preset. This preset actually looks better to start with, actually. Alright, anyway. Long Caucasian, yes. Let's skip to the presets. Guy looks too old there. Oh, no. Oh, back. Alright, so there's our preset. I'm afraid it's gonna, like, permanently. Eye color, dark brown. Shape. Wide? No. Better. We're gonna have to get rid of that beard, though. I'm not good at details. Bridge depth. Looks good. Nostril tilt, snub it high in the air. I guess that works. I'm up. Mouth. That's nice. Don't care. Cheeks, sure. Low, whatever, pronounced. Yeah. Concave or convex, that's good. Jaw, yeah, I don't care. Chin, no. I don't get how these are different, but whatever. Tone. Have a nice tan. Flushed. Oh. That looks good. Or doesn't. I'm clearly not a designer. See, I don't even know the term for it. Yeah, I don't know. Facial artist? Makeup artist? Yeah, whatever. Tone. We already did tone. Shape. We did shape. Okay. Oh, we're done the face. Hairstyle. Alright. Sarge? No. I do not want to look like I'm on drugs. Come over. Yeah, no. Always an option. Buzz cut seems too clean cut for the wasteland. Wish there were more options. The Unsettler. No. get rid of that beard first. Yeah. I'm gonna start to skip through most of this. Alright. So, I messed around a little, went back to the preset, and this is what we have. We have the better angled hair and a rough beard. Pete is a survivalist. He liked to travel, which is why he became a courier. So, yeah, so he's scoring the rough beard. He doesn't really care about his hair. And really, when you're traveling the wasteland, why shouldn't you care about your hair? It's the last thing to care about. Oh, is that like another tacit insult, Doc? I mean, you saved my life, but come on. I guess you earned the right to... Oh, blurry, I can't see. Good. Insult me.
Why don't you walk down to the end of the road?
That's what that is.
Over by that vigor tester machine.
Vigor tester.
Take it slow now. It ain't a race.
Should I race him? Oh, look. Wait. I win.
You're looking good so far.
Yeah, see?
Go ahead and give the vigor tester a try.
Woot.
We'll learn right quick if you get back on.
Looking good, right, Doc? Alright, so strength. Strength is always good, especially since I'm going to be playing on hardcore mode and carrying a lot of stuff. So barrel chested seems nice. I am not your average Joe. Perception. Yeah, I want to be a big-eyed tiger. Endurance. Unstoppable. Charisma, intelligence. I think this is good. I would want to put something into agility, though. But I don't want to take any out of charisma. Alright. I'll be an alert coyote. Reason being, I like perception is because I'm playing with realistic dynamic and dynamic combat. So it's really you're in a much better position if you get the jump on your opponents than if they get the jump on you. So it's always good to have perception. But I want agility too. Luck I can always upgrade later. All right. So six, yeah. All right, well.
Yeah, that's a pretty standard score there, but after what you've been through, I'd say that's great news.
Yeah, well, I have to change the hotkeys for the true leaning.
But that don't mean them bullets didn't leave you nuttered in a bighorn and drop.
Really well,
what do you say you take a seat in my couch and we go through a couple of questions?
Yeah, I really gotta change that.
So
you really gotta turn some lights on, Doc. Oh, did I just turn it off? I did. Sorry. Alright. Yeah, that's realistic interior, or interior lighting overall. Okay.
Alright. I'm gonna say a word. I want you to say the first thing that comes to mind.
Seems simple enough.
Dog.
Cat. Yeah.
House.
Food. This doesn't work, does it? Shelter. Yeah, sure.
Night.
Dog. Dog. Campfire, sure.
Enemy.
Friend. Aw. Swiss cheese. Reasonable, sure.
Light.
Dark. Woo. Inspiration. I said dark, though.
Mother.
Father. Well, you see, Pete's mother, he never knew his mother. His mother died in childbirth. And, of course, he really doesn't know his father much because of his head problems, but he thinks he did not like his father, and his father was, yeah, which is one of the reasons why he got out of there instead of traveling and became a courier. So, mother, regret, yeah.
Okay. Now, I got a few statements. I want you to tell me how much they sound like something you'd say. First one, conflict just ain't in my nature.
I don't know. Probably will be in my nature in the future. But, you know, I disagree.
I ain't given to relying on others for support.
Grammar, man. I'm not sure if I even understood that question. I ain't given on relying on others for support. I don't like relying on others for support. I disagree.
I'm always fixing to be the center of attention.
That's never a good thing in the Wasteland, is it? That draws the attention of the wrong people. I ain't fixing to be the center of attention, is that what he said? Or I'm always, no, I'm always, okay, I strongly disagree.
I'm slow to embrace new ideas.
Am I? No opinion.
I charge in to deal with my problems head on.
That won't get me killed, so no.
Almost done here.
What the
what
heck?
What do you say you have a look at this?
It's like...
Tell me what you see.
Are those like two scorpion glands? Or a giant moth? Angry Chudan. I don't see the two heads though. Oh, wait. No. A shadow in a dark room. Don't see it. Let's go with a broken chain. Yeah, I can see that.
Okay. How about this one?
A ship at sea? Yes. Too embarrassed to say what it looks like.
Last one.
A bear high-fiving Bigfoot, and those are clouds. I can see them. Alright, a light in the darkness. Don't see it. Oh, okay, I think I see it. Mushroom cloud, yeah. A head on a pillow. Looks like the Grinch, if it's a head on a pillow. I don't know. A bearded man, yeah, that probably makes the most sense.
Well, that's all she wrote.
Who's she?
I don't have nothing.
You have a wife?
To, so maybe you better just have a look at the
Can
results.
I meet her?
See if it all seems right to you.
Sure thing. Alright. So like I said, Pete is a survivalist. So... Wait, let me just get it off of all these. So he's good at survival. Is that supposed to improve my tech skills? I'm not sure. So he's good at surviving. Well, if he's in a survival, medicine is always good, and repair. Or speech. Sneak, maybe. Yeah. Explosives. Alright. That looks good. Sneaker repair. I don't know. Both are very useful. So yeah, you can't tell, I'm playing a survival character. Well, yeah, campfires, a lot of crafting and cooking stuff. Because I think that fits the, it's a good role-playing, character.
Before I turn you loose, I need one more thing from you.
Alright.
We got a form for you to fill out so I can get a sense of your medical history. Just a formality. Ain't like I expect to find you got a family history of getting shot in the head.
Maybe my mother was shot in the head. Alright, yes. Trigger discipline. Wild Wasteland, yes. Logan's Loophole. Put your pet and you're gonna stay young forever. You'll never gain can be coming to camps in the last twice a lot. Yeah, no. Claustro for early bird. Quarter. You gain plus 25 pounds to your carrying capacity, but suffer minus. I probably will never drop below 75%, because I am a hoarder, and I guess if you want to survive, you have to be a hoarder. But yeah, I want to go with Trigger Discipline and Wild Wasteland, because Wild Wasteland's always awesome, and Trigger Discipline makes sense. 20% more slowly, ammo's more important.
Alright, I guess that about does it.
Indeed it does. Alright. I need to change. It's a nice little skull you got there. Whoa, move paperweight. Anything? I'm gonna take your pencil. Dang it, I really gotta change that. Let's do so now. True leaning. Left key, I don't think V and B have anything. So, that's gonna work. Back. Alright, continue. Before I reach your door. Oh, what's in the footlocker? Why doesn't control crouch? I'm gonna have to really mess with these settings. Footlocker. Why doesn't it say it's empty? Buffalo gourd seed. Sorry, Doc. Then I'm like milking you. Ooh, flashlight handheld. That could be useful for a lot of stuff, but I'm sure you'll get resupply and stim pack. And I'll make sure. Oh, I should have read that. I'll make sure to pay you back. Oh, bottle caps. Don't mind if I do. Sorry, Doc. Like I said. What the heck? Oh! Sorry, I don't want to. Nah, I'm. I don't know. I don't want to start out with any loadout. Voice modulator implant. Don't mind if I do. Oh, I might. Yeah, take a step back. Radix. That's always good. I'm not gonna milk you for everything you have, Doc. Don't worry. Oh, I know a 25 grade repair. Well, that's disappointing. What's this? Lucky Spurs. Yes. Oh, that turns it off. Alright. I'm ready, Doc.
These are yours. It was all you had on you when you was brought in. I hope you don't mind, but I gave the note a look. I thought it might help me find a next of kin.
No problem, I can understand.
Well, if you're heading back out there,
you
ought to have this.
What is it?
They call it a Pip-Boy. I grew up in one of them vaults they made before the war. We all got one. Ain't much use to me now, but you might want such a thing after what you've been through.
I appreciate it, Doc.
Like having something taken from you.
You do.
And put this on, too, so the locals don't
mind
pick on you.
Telling
me
your
modesty.
Life story.
Never was much my style, anyway.
Thank you. Shouldn't have gone through my stuff. No, he just saved my life. No, I'm not gonna start being mean to him.
Don't mention it. It's what I'm here for.
Such
you
a nice
should
guy.
Talk to Sunny Smiles before you leave town. She can help you learn to fend for yourself in the desert. She'll likely be at the saloon. I reckon some of the other folks at the saloon might be able to help you out, too. And the metal fella, Victor, who pulled
Victor.
You out of your grave. Anyway, you ever get hurt out there, you Victor. Come right back. I'll fix you up. But try not to get killed anymore.
Yeah, yes, we're going on hardcore mode. Wait, Doc,
I expect you'll be wanting to go outside after being cooped up for so long, but if you have any questions, I'll answer what I can.
Your eyes look really scary right now. I'm speech 1930. Don't I at least get a lollipop? Yeah, no. Oh, yes. Mind telling me the name?
Good Springs, named after the water we got here just down the road to the southeast. Good Springs Source, they call it. It's a quiet town, and that's how we like it. We don't go looking for trouble, though occasionally it sees fit to come looking for us.
Looking for us. Do you mean me, or is there something else going on in this town besides me? I'll have to check that out. Who was it that rescued me again?
That'd be Victor. Curious fella. He's sort of odd, and I don't just mean because he's a robot.
Robot.
I couldn't tell you much about him. He's real friendly, don't get me wrong. You just get the sense that that ain't the whole picture. Just a feeling. He keeps to himself, mostly. You want to know more about him, you'll have to ask him yourself. He has a shack on the southern edge of town.
Okay. What else can you tell me about Good Springs?
Well, there's a general store just up the road, run by a fella named Chet.
Chet, got it.
He don't got nothing fancy, but he's got your basics covered. If you're looking to wet your whistle, just past Chet's
wet
is the Prospector
whistle?
Saloon. The bartender there, Trudy, knows everyone in town. Other than that, there's not much to see.
I can't say I've heard that
term.
People
trying
before.
To scratch out a living.
Okay. Seems like a peaceful town. Do you know anything about that man that shot me?
I didn't see him or the men with him. You might ask around town, though. Could be someone saw which way they was headed. Your
right.
Best bet would probably be Trudy, the bartender at the saloon up the road. If anyone saw anything, she'd know about it.
I'll be sure to ask her. Yeah, I have nothing better to do, Doc. Why don't you tell me your life story?
Well, I already told you I came from a vault. After that, I was a traveling doctor for a spell.
Interesting.
It seemed like a good idea at the time. Most folks out here ain't educated, so people with medical know-how are hard to come by. I found that I could help a lot of people with what I knew, and that was all right with me. Eventually, I went back and married my childhood sweetheart, and that was the end of my traveling days.
So where
Didn't
is she?
Miss it none then. Still don't.
You said before you had something taken from you.
Well, ain't we all, right? That was a long time ago. I don't pay it much mind anymore.
You're not gonna, like, send me on some quest? I wish someone would create a quest for, Doc Mitchell having something taken from him. Yeah.
You take care now.
Goodbye. I sure will. Be sure to repay you. I owe you big time, man. Doc. I will never forget this, what you did. I will never disappoint you. Alright. Open the door to Good Springs. Let's roll.
Yippee-yay!